Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture series of radar systems. Today's topic is non-coherent MTI radar. In this video I am going to discuss the block diagram of non-coherent MTI radar and what is the difference between coherent and non-coherent radar. Let us begin. To start with understanding what is non-coherent MTI radar, let us first differentiate in between the coherent and non-coherent. See, the echo signal which is received from a moving target or from a clutter, it fluctuates both in amplitude and phase. So when MTI makes use of phase fluctuation, then it is known as a coherent MTI. And when amplitude fluctuations is being considered, that is known as a non-coherent MTI. So now you will be able to differentiate between the coherent and non-coherent MTI. So a radar which uses clutter signal as a reference signal to extract Doppler shifted target, that is known as a non-coherent MTI radar. It is also known as a externally coherent MTI radar. And in non-coherent MTI radar, as I've told you, that the amplitude fluctuations are used to recognize the Doppler component which is produced by the moving target. That is why it is also known as an externally coherent MTI radar. This is the block diagram of a non-coherent MTI radar. Here you can see a single antenna is being used. Means via this particular antenna only the information or the signal is being transmitted, and this is from this antenna the signal is being received also. That is why duplexer is being used. So during transmission it will connect the antenna with the transmitter section, while during the reception it will connect the antenna with the receiving section. Here magnetron is being used for the generation of the signal which is to be transmitted, modulator and trigger that will control the signal which is being transmitted now. So when the signal is being transmitted from this transmitter section, it will be transmitted via the antenna, and during the availability of the target, some of the transmitted signal will be reflected back, which is actually the echo signal that is being received, and now that will be received and will be processed through the receiver section. So here you can see first stage is what, mixer local oscillator. So this RF is being converted into an IF over here with the help of the mixer and local oscillator. And when you are observing this particular circuit, then you must remember that in the case of non-coherent MTI, amplitude limiter is not used. So there is no use of amplitude limiter. You must remember it. This is not used because otherwise the desired amplitude fluctuations would be lost if amplitude limiter is used. So instead of using phase detector, here you can observe amplitude detector is used. Therefore, IF amplifier, the characteristic or the nature of this IF amplifier, it should be linear and it should have large dynamic range. So IF amplifier, it must be linear and it must have large dynamic range, which is the required characteristic in the case of the non-coherent MTI. And sometimes a logarithmic amplifier can also be used as a IF amplifier to have logarithmic gain characteristics, like protection from saturation or having uniform output with variations in clutter input amplitude. And here you can see the output of IF amplifier to be detected through the amplitude detector. And the output of amplitude detector, it may be further processed either using delay line canceller or it may be detected over A scope. So there are various ways via which it can be observed. And Doppler filter, just to remove the unwanted component, the noise also. So here the output of amplitude detector, it can be processed depending upon the requirement, and there are two ways, as I've told you, delay line canceller or by using the A scope. So if the output is being observed on a A scope, then the output will looks like a butterfly effect. and this is only because of the change or the Doppler, due to the Doppler in amplitude fluctuations. And the transmitter section, which you have seen over here, which consists of magnetron, modulator, trigger, the transmitter section, it should be stable over the pulse duration. Then only it is going to prevent beat from overlapping ground clutter. That is also a requirement. So that is why the transmitter must be very, very stable over here. And the major advantage of non-coherent MTI radar or MTI is its construction is very simple. This is very simple and it may be used anywhere where space and weight are the limited. So on those particular places, in those particular applications where space and weight are the major challenge and they have to be optimized, so MTI, non-coherent MTI can be used over there. The function of each block of the MTI radar, this I have already discussed, but I have listed out over here, so you can take a note. Advantage, I have already told you that it is a very simple and it could be used at all those places where space and weight are the major challenges. But improvement factor of a non-coherent MTI is not good. So improvement factor needs to be increased. Thank you so much for watching this video.